knocked Gordon Ramsay's socks off when he won MasterChef Junior.
Since then, he was named one of the young innovators changing the world by Forbes magazine, and he won the James Beard Award for his famous sustainable mushroom monster burger. Please say hello to Chef Logan Guleff.
Wow. Thank you.
An accomplished chef at such a young age, 15?
You know, I really started taking off when I was 8. I'm 15 now. Yes. And so revisiting all those recipes and being like, well, I was so much younger then. My palate wasn't quite where it is now. And yeah. Now I need more smoky. I need more savory. I need a sweeter element in this. And just really recreating those dishes.
That's unbelievable.
You're passionate about cooking.
Oh, man, I love
cooking. It's amazing.
It's just the most fun.
It's so cool because, I mean, you meet other... I mean, James Beard Award is the award for cooking.
It's like
the Oscar. Like, you win the Academy Award.
Mm-hmm.
When you meet other James Beard Award winners and you're 15 and they're like been doing this all their life, are they kind of like, hey, you little whippersnapper? Like, are they like, do they embrace you or do they?
Well, every chef has a test. And so, like, really, like, cracking the test and beating it and showing them, well, I am a real chef. I really do cook. I really know what I'm doing. And I really love it. It is always, like, fun. And I've tried, like, everything. I've tried from coffee to, like, the temperature of a sauce to, like, what dish is better. They've tried everything. And when I was 8, I started winning my first recipe contest and really took off from there. And I have a really long life story.
I feel like a loser right now. I got to step it up. I can barely boil water. You're going to show me how it's done, though, right?
So today we are making roasted beet toast. So right over there, Ben, you've got your roasted beet. How I dress it. You want to wrap it in tin foil and then roast it. So now you can open that one up. Now getting rid of the peel is really, really simple and easy. You just simply just like take your paper towel and just... Wipe it off. Just wipe it off.
Just wipe it off like this?
Yeah, just go like that. You know, it should really come off real easy.
Oh, just peel it off, Ben. Yeah.
You know, just get in there. Don't worry. That's just a trivial step.
We cleaned the beets. We have cleaned the beets.
All right, the beets clean.
Skin is removed.
We got clean beets.
All right, so now we're moving on to our gastrique.
Gastrique. Yeah, what is it?
So, a gastrique.
Gastrique.
Uh-huh. So, it's a French mother sauce, equal parts vinegar to sugar. Now, I'm using honey.
All right.
And now this is the dangerous part, so you might want to step back a little.
Mm-hmm.
Ooh. Wow.
Normally it makes a much louder sound. Sorry about that.
I'm wearing a bow tie. Nothing's dangerous.
All right,
dangerous.
So now you just kind of give it a stir.
You want to go for it?
Just stir it. So now, Ben, if you could add in the spices. Now this is spiced honey gastrique.
Yeah. What is this?
I believe that's nutmeg.
Nutmeg.
Awesome.
And then we have cinnamon.
Cinnamon.
And then we have star anise.
Star anise. Look at that. This
is actually pretty cool.
Fancy.
And then we have 2 cardamom pods. And some cracked black pepper.
Wow.
Now, one of the things about using whole spices is they really impart like so much flavor.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
Because you get
smell it.
Every
can
part.
Smell that?
Do you cook for your friends?
Sometimes. I try not to go too chef on them because then they go like, oh my God, this kid's crazy and insane. He can tell me like every single component in there and what it needs. So now we have our gastrique here. Now you can see.
Interesting consistency.
It's thicker. You just cook this down until you get it to the thickness you want. And also another key thing is it should coat the back of a spoon. It's another cool thing about sauces is it should coat the back of a spoon. And there we go. Now we've done that.
Amazing.
So we can move down.
Oh.
Okay. Now, this is step 2. We have to assemble our toast.
All
so we already have our toasted here. And we have kind of our whipped goat cheese spread.
Whipped goat cheese?
So now that's just goat cheese, half and half, in a stand mixer. It's simple. You just take it.
Spread it on there.
You know, so now you want to finish, and then you just layer on your beets. So now
you spread all layer.
On there.
So now you just kind of layer them like one after another. You can
you
kind of do like a little design. Kind of layer them like fish scales almost.
Okay.
Uh-huh.
Oh, there you
Beautiful.
Go. That looks
nice.
Great. So now we're going to swap that out for the ones that we've already toasted.
Now, how do you come up with your recipes?
How do I come up with my recipes? Well, what I do is I start with my objective, which is to make something delicious.
Absolutely.
And then I go to the market and... just kind of shop it out.
Put it all together.
Yeah.
And probably invent things while you're in the kitchen.
Oh, of course.
Yes.
Of course. When you're combining flavors and combining textures, that you're making your own masterpiece.
Absolutely.
And a chef is really an artist.
Yes.
So my art is not the art of plating. It's the art of flavors.
Ah.
Absolutely.
And
the art
really
of flavor.
Getting there.
That's the name of your first cookbook, Art of Flavor.
Actually, my first cookbook.
Never mind.
I already have one. So... Thank you.